If you're building an EV, obviously you need an electric motor. Now, they make purpose-built motors like the Warp 9 that are intended to be used in EV conversions, but they're also expensive compared to a salvaged motor. Forklift motors are generally large, which can be inconvenient, but they're cheap and they're sometimes tolerant of overvolting, or running more voltage through them than they were designed for. When we saw a used forklift motor for sale on an EV conversion forum, we decided the price was low enough that we ought to take the leap. Damn it. The motor is advanced, capable of taking up to 120 volts DC. It was previously installed in a converted Toyota EV, but even if it doesn't work, we won't have broken our budget. The motor was being sold by a guy in Atlanta, Georgia. With us located in Pittsburgh, we could have had it shipped, but we chose to drive to get it. Driving cost about the same, and we were also tired of being cooped up due to quarantine. It was time for a road trip.
Hotel bathroom. I'm just gonna go in and turn on the lights. See, now this is really great. If your friend is using the toilet, you can turn out the lights for them. Shower, door, hey! And there's an obvious gap here. They must have known about this when they made it, right? And this must really secretly be a good idea. And then you shower for 2 minutes and you look at the floor. All right, so show me what this controller is again.
You know, are y'all computer? Y'all,
yeah.
Y'all know what open source is?
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Okay, so there was a guy out of Washington who developed an open source controller. Mm-hmm. This is a 500 amp, 144 volt. They call it the Paul and Sabrina controller. 500 amps goes from 0 to 144 volts. It's got to have an external 12 volt supply. But other than that, it's very, very good. It's very robust. It's more robust than all the other 500 amp controllers out there.
And this is a hybrid you're building here, so this is a gas engine.
This
and
is
that's
a diesel
the
engine. This is a diesel.
Diesel, and this is the same electric motor.
Yeah, that's a GE motor, just like what you got over there. That's a GE motor too. There's slight things that are one slight difference to this motor. This motor has an extra terminal, which it's in your case you're going to run it on that high voltage is good. These two terminals is a SEPX terminal. That's for a separately excited field. There's two fields in here that are series, and then there's two fields that are SEPX. When your foot pedal, you want to be able to switch this on to 48 volts. Push your pedal, a switch, a solenoid switches on 48 volts to these terminals. And these are, of course, is your series stuff down here. This motor will not do regen.
But ours will.
Yours will, because you have a SEPX coil up here. Put 48 volts on there, then it and as it's spinning, it becomes a generator. But you need the
controller
to be able to take that power and dump it back into the batteries. There's a controller on eBay, a 500 amp, it's from Hungary. It's a 500 amp, 144 volt. You got to do a search that will do regen. I think they call this all-to welding cable. This connects all your high voltage, high powered stuff from your controller to the motor to the battery pack.
So this is the pedal?
Potentiometer pedal. I got this on eBay, but it comes out, you know, two of these are the switch and the three of these are the potentiometer.
On our way back north, we passed one of the largest EV battery factories in America, a brand new facility outside Atlanta. In fact, the president of South Korea was visiting the facility that weekend and may even have been in the building as we drove past. I cannot relate to the kind of person who would destroy these mountains to dig up coal to pollute these skies. But of course, in capitalism, the robber barons who benefit from these mountains being leveled do not live here.
Shit, I got my finger in the shot. I have to do this over again.
Ethical consumption is not really possible in this economic system. Even our project, an electric vehicle, is only as clean as the electricity that powers it. And its batteries require mining rare earth elements in places that were once as beautiful as this. We're going with lithium iron phosphate batteries in part because they do not require destructive cobalt and nickel mining practices, but unfortunately, they still require lithium. Policymakers and industry need to develop alternative battery chemistries, or the clean air over skies like these will come at the expense of those over Bolivia, and that would not sit right with me. Of course, this problem is a little over scope for our little project.
I was showing this to my activist buddies, and they were like, what does the wood do?
It's no. The fuel.
It's like, that is a box, so you can carry it. Dave called these USB plugs.
Yeah, in case you need to charge your phone under your truck.
And it's installed, so there you go.
Just use this thing. It's not hard to use anyway, because we can just clamp onto each terminal and then...
Now, I'm guessing that it's not as bad to put a 12-volt current through it without a load than...
What we're going to do probably is just touch it to one of the contacts and just let it spin for a second. And
yeah.
Take it
yeah.
Off.
Yep.
All doomed.
Well, I only got we're all doomed, so that seems appropriate.
Yeah, we are all doomed, though. A little bit of courage.
If this doesn't work, we're all doomed.
We want to put gloves on just in case?
Yeah, it can't hurt. I mean, it could hurt, which is why you want to put gloves on.
You want to get the
yeah. You probably want to get on the spindle over there.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. You mean the camera? I thought you meant touch it. I'm like
yeah,
no.
Yeah.
Oh,
grab
no, no,
onto no. it real hard.
Yes.
Yeah, it works. Sounds great.
That's what our car is gonna sound like.
There you go.
So.
Cool.
That's it. We've got a car. It's done.
This light has been pathetic from day one of owning this vehicle, so we're going to replace it with an LED.
We found a new specimen. This is Lepidopterus japonicus, and it's been stuck in this light probably a very long time.
That's part of its natural life cycle.
12 volt, 5 watt only in this.
Well, this is 1 watt because it's
12
an LED.
Volt, 1 watt. Oh, yeah, okay.
It's fine. We're going to be saving 4 watts.
Oh, it's so not much brighter.
It is substantially better.
Although it's not as warm. I kind of prefer the fireside chat kind of feel.
Franklin Roosevelt was in the car with me.
Are we keeping the bug in it?
Well, are you going to put it between some like laminate and put it with your collection?
No, I'm good.
Oh, come on, it's all the way from Japan. He's traveled very far.
He's migratory, yeah. I think we can clean this while it's out.
Put it in the compost heap.
We have made serious progress here. We have now replaced the original incandescent 5-watt gas-guzzling light bulb with this single-watt LED bulb, which I can look at it without my eyes burning.
Yes, we know it didn't actually guzzle gas. It's a joke. But also, this car's electronics will eventually all be driven off of batteries. These efficiency savings are going to end up affecting the range of the vehicle. Tune in next time as we install our homemade radio transmitter.